Hi everyone. The Scanning Manager in Optuma is a very powerful and flexible feature that you can use to create your own scans on any technical conditions and timeframes that you want to look for opportunities in the market. So to get to the Scanning Manager, we'll click on the Searches menu button and you'll see it listed at the top there. You can also use the keyboard shortcut of the Alt key plus S. And that'll bring up the Scanning Manager window. So on the left-hand side where it says New Scan in blue, we can double-click on that to give it a name. So I'm going to do, in this example, a scan on volume. I'm going to call it Daily Volume. And then just click away. And then in the middle window, in the security selection, I'm going to change it from a single code. So instead of looking at just one ticker symbol, I'm going to look at multiple codes over an exchange. So I can then click on codes to scan. I can select an exchange. I can select a workbook. So if you've got your portfolio listed in a workbook, we can scan on that. And also symbol lists. So if you've seen the symbol list video already, you'll know how to import CSV files or create manual lists of your favorite ticker symbols. So I've got one here on the NASDAQ 100. So I'm going to select that. Date range is the period I'm going to scan over. So we can click on that for the drop down. If we did something like last year, then it will return a result, the very first result that happened over the last year. So I'm going to do just last bar for this one. And the time frame, again, we can change it from daily, weekly, monthly, which is used to base on the script, on the formula. So if we're looking at daily volume, obviously you want to keep that to one day. But if we want to look at weekly or monthly volume, we can change the time frame there. And I'll give an example of that in a little bit. So now we click in the scan criteria window, click the plus icon there, and this will bring up a list of all the default criteria or scans that we have pre-built into the system. Now, to get the most power out of this, the Scanning Manager requires you can learn the scripting language, the Optuma scripting language that will make it possible to put any criteria that you like into this Scanning Manager. So again, I keep mentioning this in other videos, but learn.optuma.com for the scripting courses, and you will be able to learn from the very basics of scripting up to some quite advanced ones. But for this video, I'll just show you some of the default criteria that we've got. So you can see there, it's all listed alphabetically: ADX, Bollinger Bands, CCI, and even some GAN swings and moving averages and so on. But what we can do is type to search. So this is going to be on volume. So I'm just going to type volume in that search box. And from the list that's displayed, I'm going to select volume greater than value. And that's now added to the criteria, but now I want to specify that value that I want to scan on. So when I click that box, the script editor window comes up. So the default setting is volume greater than 500,000, but let's say I want to change this to 5 million. So I'm just going to stick an extra zero on the end there. And then what I'm going to do is apply that script. Now, because I'm changing one of the saved scripts that's already in there, it's prompting me if I want to update this. If I didn't, I could save this script as in that button there at the bottom of the script editor window. But in this example, I'm just going to click yes to overwrite that script. And now that's been closed, we can now execute the scan. So that's going to run through that symbol list of NASDAQ 100, and I got 28 results for yesterday. So we can click export results, and then we can put those into a new workbook, add to the current workbook that we have open, or I can open results as and go to chart all. And if you've seen the chart layouts video, we can automatically apply that to the chart. So let's open up with a weekly layout. And you can see we can close that window in the top right corner. So now that's added those results to this workbook using the weekly layout with the tools and indicators that are applied to that layout. Now, if we click on the searches menu button again, go back to the scanning manager, we can also export the results as a watch list. So that's just added those results in that column, and we can double click and apply layouts and even page layouts as well. So we can open as page layouts, or we can click here. This WL1, because this is a page layout with a watch list, we can use that one, and that will put the three different chart types next to our watch list. Now you'll notice that when we've opened this watch list from the Scanning Manager results, you'll see that there's a chain icon here. And now that means, saying daily volume, that means that this is now linked to that scan. So if we actually go down to the properties, you can see that it's linked to list. And the list that's being used is the daily volume. So that's the name of the scan that I created. So that means when we save this workbook or this tab in the workbook, we open it tomorrow, it's going to automatically rerun that scan. So this list could very well be very different tomorrow, because obviously the scanning criteria will have changed. So that's a great way of quickly and looking at results without having to physically run the scan again. You can just save this watch list that's linked to that scan, and whenever you open the workbook, the scan will be rerun and this list will be repopulated. Now, if you don't want that to happen, we can simply unlink the list. So when we click on the watch list and go down to the properties, we can just untick the link to list, and now this list is static. So we'll come back tomorrow. This watch list will be exactly the same, and the scan won't have been run. I'm going to close this workbook and do another example. So file, close workbook. Do I want to save the changes? No, I don't. I'm just going to discard that and go back to the searches menu and the scanning manager. You'll notice that there's a little plus sign in the criteria window. So when we click that, we can add extra criteria. So in this search box, I am going to type price. So price or value greater than price. So I'm going to click on that. And that's now added the and between those two criterias. When I click on that, I can change it to or. So if I wanted to do another volume, I could do volume greater than 5 million or price greater than 50. But let's do and greater than. So I'm going to click on the button there to bring up this criteria. And here we've got closing price greater than 30. But in that example, I'm just going to do 50. I'm going to replace that with 50, apply that. Yes, I want to overwrite. And when I execute that scan again, I'm likely to get fewer results because there's extra criteria. And exactly, instead of 28 last time, I get 11. And I can export those results, open results as page layout, and there's the WL1, which will automatically open those. I can roll that panel away, give us more space. And that's my scan results for yesterday. Couple more examples changing timeframes. So again, going back into the scanning manager, you'll notice when I click the new, I can add a group or an individual item. So a group is like a folder. So if you've got all your volume scans or moving average scans, whatever you like. So I'm going to add a group, and I'm just going to call this test. And then what I can do is move existing scans into that group. So now we've got the daily volume scan in that group. When I select that, I can now clone it. So when I click that clone button, it's now made a copy of the daily volume scan. But what I want to do this time, instead of daily, I'm just going to double click on that label on the left hand side and rename that weekly volume. And this time I'm going to keep date range at last bar, but I'm going to change it to week. So now this volume calculation, which is 5 million, that's going to be based on the week rather than the day. So I'm going to change that to 10 and then apply that, keep the change, and then execute scan. And again, you'll see there's different number of results. We've got 23 this time. That's because this is now based on the weekly volume rather than the last day. So I hope that was useful, a quick overview of the Scanning Manager. Again, highly recommend learning the scripting language and even the very basics so you can create your own criteria on any technical indicator that you can think of. And you can join criteria together using the AND function so you can really drill down universe of stocks into tradable actions. As always, any questions, please let us know. Thanks very much.